What's up guys, Benny here coming to you from the 44 Pro conference room. This is gonna be the first video in a series of videos that I'm gonna be making. We're gonna be putting them out every month or so, and it's just gonna be a series of videos updating you guys on the new stuff we have coming out of 44, how our pros are doing, and basically anything we can do to keep you guys the most involved that you can be in the company. So this video is gonna touch on a few things. One of them is gonna be the new kit palm liner option. I'm also gonna be touching on the new catcher's mitt builder, a few of the new products, including the wallets and the glove locks. The new 574 mesh is also gonna be touched on a little bit, and then a few other odds and ends I'm gonna throw in there just to really make the video a good one for the first video of the series. So starting with the kit palm liner, it is available on Signature Series gloves now. Basically what it is instead of having the sheepskin liner that you have on previous signatures, we're gonna give you the option to choose a kit palm liner, and I'm gonna zoom in right now to show you guys a little bit of the difference. So what I'm showing you now is the sheepskin palm liner that comes standard in our gloves, and it's gonna be only available in black. Now on the screen is the new kit palm liner, which is available in any color of leather. And basically what the kit palm liner is it's gonna be a little bit softer, it's gonna last a little bit longer, it's gonna feel a little bit smoother on your hand. So the benefits are is that it's gonna feel a little softer and smoother, a little bit more durable, and of course you can choose the color of it so you can add a little bit of flair to the inside of your glove. So next up I'll be going over the new catcher's mitt builder, which just dropped last week. What's on the new builder is the ability to see the wrist strap. So before on the catcher's mitt builder you couldn't see the wrist strap, now we've added that on. We've also added the new finger hood, which looks pretty similar to this one right here, except it has a little bit of an extra piece of leather here, so I want to be putting a picture of that in right now. The new catcher's mitt builder is also going to have new X lacing on the top of the catcher's mitt web, so I'll be showing you that right now. This is the new X lacing, and this is the older style, which is just the vertical lacing right here. So the new X lacing that I just showed you, it's just gonna add a little bit of durability to the web of the glove. Another option we have, which I don't have a picture of right now, is we've removed the 44 logo from the web of the catcher's mitt. It just makes it look a little bit cleaner than it did before. All right, so next up, we have one of the most heavily requested things, which is 574 mesh. So the 574, if you guys don't know, is a pattern with a really nice deep pocket, really nice wide, kind of squared off heel. Really popular with infielders and pitchers, even some outfielders. So a lot of people were requesting mesh on the 574, which we couldn't quite do yet, so we worked really hard. We added the option for 574 mesh, it's now on the glove builder. So if you want to get mesh on a 574, go ahead, I highly recommend it. It makes the glove a lot lighter, and I think I told you guys, the 574 is my favorite, is personally my favorite model. Just the pocket you can get in it and the break-in is so perfect. Here's the one that's slightly broken in. Really nice break-in on this model. So if you want to mesh on the 574, we listened to you, we added it to the glove builder, it is now available. So next up I'll be going over some of the recently released items at 44, including the new wallet, which I have right here. So here's the wallet looks like. Let me find mine, I have an open one that is somewhere on this table. Here it is. So here's the wallet. I'm gonna be getting up to show you guys a little bit of a close-up on it. All right, here's the wallet. Really sleek, black leather with the 44 logo right here. And then you got a 44 right here and a 44 right here as well. So really nice looking wallet. The wallet also sells for only $19. So it's a really good deal for a really high quality wallet. I've been using mine for a while now. Very nice wallet. Not really a new product, but we changed the packaging on our glove rub, so it just looks a little bit cleaner. It's black and gold now instead of white and black, so I'll be showing that to you real quick. Here's the new packaging for the glove rub. And lastly, out of the new products is the glove locks. So this is a collaboration with the glove lock at the glove lock on Instagram, Paul DeBellis. We're selling glove locks on our website now. They come in a variety of colors like white, black, red, blue, navy, tan, a few other colors as well. Basically what they do is if you ever have problems tying your glove or keeping your glove tied, these will hold the ties on the side of your gloves to really keep your fingers secured. So I'll show you right now. These are the tan glove locks right here. Really, you want to have a tight thumb and pinky because that's going to give you the best breaking on a glove. If your fingers are really loose and sliding around in your thumb or sliding around in your pinky, you're not going to have the best breaking possible. So you really want to have a tight thumb, tight pinky. And if the glove keeps coming untied, these really help out. All right, the last glove-related thing we have today is the Japanese-style catcher's mitt or Asian-style catcher's mitt. It is available by special request, and it actually has become pretty popular both in Asia, and we've had a lot of customers in the US ordering it as well. It just has a really different feel than any kind of American-style catcher's mitt you're gonna have. Really kind of, it's a lot more circular as you can see. Here's a regular style catcher's mitt. You can just see how circular this one is. Really round, a really big pocket for a catcher's mitt. Usually, especially when I'm breaking in my mitts, and I know a lot of other catchers as well, like to have a box form, kind of like this. So this is just a complete switch up. Definitely recommend it. It's really fun to play catch with. And if you break it incorrectly, could be a definite gamer behind the plate. Okay, so last thing I want to touch on today is our pros. In the last 2 weeks, I think we've had 4 or 5 guys make their MLB debuts. A few guys make their first MLB starts. We've had a lot of big moments for both our guys in the big leagues and in the minor leagues. So some of the coolest pro things that have happened recently, in my opinion at least, Freddy Peralta on Milwaukee striking out 13 in his MLB debut, breaking the Milwaukee record for most strikeouts by a rookie. Also, David Hess in Baltimore having 2 solid starts for his first 2 pro appearances. We also have Franmil Reyes recently called up in San Diego. He was absolutely tearing it up in the minors. I think he had 14 home runs, almost 40 RBIs in only 36 games. So a lot of our guys are doing pretty big things right now. I know Justin Bour, he's our biggest guy in Miami. He's doing absolutely huge things as well. So talking about our pros is going to kind of segue me into my last subject for the day, which is talking about the pros' gloves. So would you guys like to see maybe a mini series in this series where every video I bring in a pros' glove and we talk about the specs of it, what they like, what they don't like, how they're doing? For example, in this video, I have one of Jose Alvarado's gloves, the pitcher for Tampa Bay. He likes a lot of black on his gloves. Most of his gloves are black with a little bit of sky blue, just like this one right here. I would obviously go more in depth, but this is just the first video, so here's one of Jose Alvarado's gloves. Just let me know down in the comments if you'd want me to do this little mini series in the main series. Just let me know down in the comments, and I'll make sure to read through all the comments to see if you guys really want it. So that's gonna wrap up the video for today, guys. Let me know down in the comments what you wanna see in the future videos. Make sure to drop a like, subscribe, but the biggest thing is comment below what you want to see from 44. If you want to see any specific gloves, any models, anything at all, let me know down in the comments. And I will see you next video.